surprised with the People's Campaign. Actually, I've not only seen, I've been to some of those events as well. It reminds me of the 1986 groundswell, but sa totoo lang, this is even more
really?
Than that.
You think you can compare it to 86?
Yeah, ako, I was in 86 from Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, and like now, as I said, I've also part of this campaign as part of Isang Bayan supporting Lenny Robredo and Kiko Pangilinan, and I think the it's not only you know, Karen, you don't look at it as the drone shot alone or the people alone. I look at it because it's not on attendance, eh? Kasi attendance can be deceiving. You can have a lot of people, but it is the energy of the people in the rally. It is the morale of the people, of the campaigners that we have on that I speak daily, every day. And as I said, yung ano nila eh, yung dedication to the person, to the campaign, to the cause of good governance and real service to the Filipino people. I think yun ang nagkakaiba and yun ang malaking pwedeng ihambing sa 86. Na sabi ko nga, mas malakas. Kasi kung titingnan mo yung 86, may galit against Marcos at that time. Ngayon, hindi naman yung kanilang fervor, yung kanilang participation, hindi galit. It is wanting real and love to the Filipino, to the Philippines, na kailangan naman po sa pagkakataon na ito, bigyan po natin ng pagkakataon magbago ang Pilipinas para sa tunay na, you know, I mean, for the benefit of the for everybody.
And what do you make of a Boying Remulla's statement saying kilala niya, alam ko galawan dyan, hakot yan. Senator Panfilo Lacson denying that he red-tagged the Robredo camp and those who attended, but in effect also insinuated that there was a coalition with the NPA or the communists, the left in some sort.
Well, to Boying Remulla, kilala niya, talagang kilala niya yung ginagawa niya. We can put it to that. Kung alam niya yung ginagawa niya, siguro siya gumagawa noon, pero hindi po kami, no? To Senator Panfilo Lacson, well, I guess that's his training as a military, as a PNP officer to put some red tag or questions to the coalition. But you know, the Filipino people is a coalition of or a group of a lot of people. We cannot segregate, be a president and say, ayoko, gusto ko lang sa hindi pula, gusto ko lang sa Dilaw, gusto ko lang sa Azul, gusto ko lang sa ganito. When you are president, you have to be president of everybody. And a coalition, there's nothing wrong or bad in a coalition government. There is nothing wrong to being inclusive. And I think what is important
here... Are you then confirming by saying that there's nothing wrong with a coalition, nothing wrong with being inclusive? Are you confirming Senator Lacson's statements then that there was a coalition?
I'm not confirming that there is a coalition with yung sinasabi niyang pula or terrorist or nagre-red tag siya, because yung mga red tag na yan are given to the terrorists and to the armed groups, not to the legal groups or not to the mainstream parliament groups, no? So if he is confirming or saying that there are terrorists or there are armed groups in the coalition, I would say none. But if there are legal groups, legal representations, whether you are to the right or to the left, then I think that can be a fair statement. But I said, those are legal groups. Those are legal representatives.
I wanted to ask you, his concern was an establishment, a coalition government with the CPP-NPA.
That's what I'm saying, Karen. I don't think there were any CPP-NPA, because CPP-NPA is a military and not a legal group. So as I said, that in itself, I don't think that there is any presence of that in any point in time, in anything that I know of or I have seen in those rallies or meetings that we might have. But if we are talking about parliamentary groups, legal groups, then I guess there's nothing wrong with having a legal group, legal representation from parliamentary groups.
On that note, Attorney Howard Galleja, anything you want to say before we go?
Well, again, I would like to thank my wife who's really standing behind me, my family and friends. And as I said, marami pong lalabas at kung meron man pong lumabas, I leave it up to you. Ito po si Attorney Calieja tapat at pumupunta sa inyo ng katotohanan. So I leave it up to the people to believe what they want to believe.
On that note, Attorney Awi Calieja, thanks for joining me today. Thank you for sharing your story, and you take care, sir.
Salamat, Karen. Thank you.